You're about to step into a brand new elevator, and suddenly you overheard the mechanic who installed it. He claimed that after testing on 10 elevators, he found that they can support, on average, about 1,000 pounds of weight. Sounds safe enough, right? Well, those tests were done on a sample of just 10 elevators. How can we be confident that all elevators, including your own, can actually hold up to 1,000 pounds? How confident can we be in that 1,000-pound average? This is where confidence intervals come in. By itself, a point estimate, or sample mean, tells us almost nothing about the population's mean. Is it far? Is it close? Instead of saying the sample's average weight limit is exactly 1,000 pounds, a confidence interval gives us a range of values. We would say something like, we are 95% confident that the true average weight limit for all elevators is between 980 and 1,020 pounds. This range is centered around our sample average, 1,000 pounds, plus or minus a bit of room, or what's called the margin of error. To find the confidence interval, we will assume that we know the population standard deviation and use a simple formula. We take our sample average, X bar, and add or subtract our margin of error, which is our critical value, Z star, multiplied by the population standard deviation, and then divided by the square root of our sample size. Notice how the standard deviation includes variability while the sample size decreases that variability. Z star in this case is a predetermined number and comes from the standard normal distribution. For 95%, it is 1.96. If you want to be more confident, let's say 99% confident, you could use a z-score of 2.57. However, this increased confidence results in a wider interval, sacrificing precision. You'll notice as well that we divide by the square root of our sample size. This critical addition causes our interval to shrink the higher our sample size is because our margin of error decreases. This means that if we tested 5 elevators, they would have a bigger margin of error than if they tested 25. So let's do our own math. Let's assume that our data is approximately normally distributed, the population standard deviation is 100, and we'll test on 40 elevators. We can then find a 95% confidence interval. So plugging this all in, we get the interval of 969 and 1031 with a 95% confidence. So what does this 95% confidence really mean? This is the part that trips up even some researchers. If you were to calculate the mean for another 10 elevators, your point estimate would probably be slightly different, and you get a slightly different confidence interval. For example, you might get 971 and 1,033. If you were then to stack these differing intervals on top of each other 100 times, you would expect the population's mean to be in that interval 95 times. Therefore, it refers more to the method than the actual value. So, when we say we're 95% confident that the true average is between 969 and 1,031 pounds, we are saying that the method we use gave us a range we are pretty confident contains all elevators' average weight limit. It would be pretty rare for our interval to be one that the 5% missed. So, what about when we don't know the population standard deviation? For instance, if we don't know what the population's average is, it is pretty unlikely we would know what the standard deviation is. Instead, we would use a slightly different formula and will be explored in a future video. To wrap up, the mechanic only tested 10 elevators. Do you think that was enough? Try calculating what their confidence interval would look like for their original sample of just 10, assuming the same standard deviation, and leave your answers down in the comments below. And if this helped you finally understand confidence intervals, make sure to like and subscribe.